In Vegas, one of the best cut man's coaches in the business, Rafael Garcia Jr. How you feeling today?
Good, sir. How you doing? Hey, Larry, good to see you in Vegas.
First of all, I'm gonna tell everybody, his dad made up or came up with the slogan, hard work, dedication. And yes. How did he come up with that? You ever ask him, like, where did that come from?
Watching Floyd Mayweather work out. The way he would watch Floyd work out, there was like nobody else. So he would come up with a lot of sayings like that, hard work and dedication, what it took to be.
And now it's on t-shirts, hats, it's everywhere. What did your dad teach you about boxing that you could share with us? Like, what were some of the sayings or some of the knowledge that he passed on?
Oh, gosh. I'm trying to think here. There's so much that he passed on. It's like, so much. Where do I begin now?
Okay, you work in a corner and you work in cuts. He was a great, great cut man, legendary. He worked with Floyd for so many. What did he tell you about being a cut man, for example? Don't panic, breathe.
To him, it was it was just natural for him. He's been in the ring with so many fighters and so many times that he was there to help the fighter, okay, to get to the next round, to the next, you know, and it wasn't, it just stopped his help with talking to doctors and things and knowing his craft. He'd be able to stop a fight and be able to give words of confidence to each guy in the corner. And with Floyd, you know, it's like, hey, it's not a big cut, don't worry about it, kind of stuff, and get your stuff going. And that would calm the fighter out instead of losing control or something like that.
Now, you yourself grew up in a gym as Mayweather grew. What do you remember from a young Floyd, and now that Floyd's become the TBE, the 50, you know, the billionaire boxer?
God works, does, he can do anything, okay? I mean, I remember seeing Floyd and as an amateur. Okay, and my dad back then knew that Floyd had a lot of potential, and that's when he was working at with Top Rank, my dad, and so and then before Floyd got signed, going to Top Rank and Bob Arum and stuff like that, which was the king of promotions, is incredible. So,
but your dad was there from day one, because it's easy to jump on a bandwagon when someone's made. Conor McGregor, he's a superstar, let me work with him. It's different when you go to a kid that has 0-0-0 and he's just starting and you don't know how it's going to go and you're investing time, money, and effort.
Well, one of the big changes with my dad, because Floyd had a lot of people to work with at that time, okay? And my dad was with Top Rank and worked with a lot of fighters. And there was a fight between Diego Corrales and Floyd.
Of course.
And, you know, my dad was friends with both of them, okay? And it was funny, it came down to a decision with, I'm trying to think of Mr. Diaz, Miguel Diaz, okay? He was working with Top Rank at that time too. And Miguel decided to work with
Diego,
okay? And after that, he opened the door for my dad to work with Floyd.
And never looked back.
Looked back.
Loyalty is a big thing with Floyd.
Huge.
Who's, besides Floyd, who are some of your favorite fighters that you worked with? You worked with Edwin Valero, the legend, 35-0, 35 knockouts. Who else?
Let's see. Florencio Zuniga, okay, a middleweight, helped him become a middleweight champion of a WIBO at that time. And let's see. Of course, there's Cesar Chavez, okay?
You worked with Senior?
I didn't work with him, but my dad knew him when he was younger and stuff like that. Just so many fights.
Going to MGM.
Oh,
thanks.
Okay.
Oh, you want to just drop me off anywhere? Here, I'll walk.
No,
I'm very close.
That's fine.
No, we're good.
Fine.
Thank you so much. No, I'm okay. Listening. So your dad worked with Senior. Senior's a great person, great fighter, 89-0 at one point. The legend. In Mexico, no one's bigger. And by the way, I want to tell people, if you're ever in El Paso, go check out the Rafael Garcia Museum. El Paso, Texas.
Thank you. That's
I've been there.
Yes. That's it's in El Paso. Yes, it's. I'm trying to think of Dr. Rafael Armandades runs it and stuff like that, and with keeping my dad's name alive in the boxing world, and it's a beautiful museum. A lot of boxers have donated a lot of memorabilia stuff from big fights that they've had, and now. They've got a wrestling, big-time wrestling kind of Mexican wrestlers and American wrestlers and stuff like that. A lot of memorabilia stuff.
That's awesome.
Blue Diamond.
Is there a website for it if people want to go check it out?
I'm sure there is.
I think it's the RafaelGarciaMuseum.com. But I just Google Rafael Garcia Museum Boxing and it will come up.
In El Paso. There you go.
What's your strongest memory, whether in life or in a gym, with your dad and Floyd when you were there? What stands out to you the most?
Wow. One of the times that Floyd and his father, Floyd Sr., and my dad and I got together, and we greeted each other as like a small little family, and it was a big time then. And the way Floyd would, Floyd always seemed to be like a younger brother, because my dad was with Floyd so much that, you know. I just love Floyd.
And part of the family.
Like, yeah.
Floyd's a great person. He has a big heart. A lot of people don't know. When he does charities, it's not for the media.
No.
And I've been around where, unfortunately, fighters pass away. And sometimes a fighter passes away and people think the fighter was living large. But unfortunately, him and his family really have nothing. And Floyd steps up. But nobody knows these things. They always see, like, the flashy or the money made. But he's really a good person.
No, and he's earned all that to again, I mean, do what... Blessed, God has blessed him so much that he can do those kind of things and still take care of a lot of people.
That's
and
true.
So, again, in keeping boxing alive, I mean, it does. He's an incredible man. He has a lot of things, and he's still young, and he's got his kids and growing up, and it's a beautiful thing.
Does he come back and fight Pacquiao one more time?
You never know. You never know. If the money was right, I'm sure he'd do it, you know? Get to his number, I'm sure he will.
What know? Happens in that fight?
Floyd wins again. That guy stays in shape no matter what. He takes care of himself, and he's a smart... My dad...
No damage in all his 50 fights, almost. He barely lost a round.
With my dad, Floyd was always one of the smartest fighters there was. I mean, really. I mean, from Roberto Duran to Vito Andofermo to Floyd Mayweather, I mean, it's incredible. Muhammad Ali, you know, it's funny because the first fighter I got to meet was when I was 4 years old. It was Sonny Liston.
Wow.
Okay, that my dad introduced me to. So I was like, oh, okay. Jeez.
That's awesome. Do you remember that when you were four? I can't remember anything past before five.
I remember him because he scared the heck out of me.
He's so big.
He was intimidating. He had big dark glasses, you know. He was huge to me.
Yeah.
I was four, and it was like, oh, I didn't want to get next to him because I was scared. I was like, okay. And then my dad said, oh, no, come on. He's a really nice guy. And then, of course, son, I got to meet him and shake his hand and took a picture with him. So
that
was a big thing to me.
All right. Tell everybody where to follow you on Instagram if they're watching.
Facebook? Facebook. Yes, Facebook. I don't do too much social media.
Rafael Garcia Jr., but very nice person. Giving me a ride now to my hotel. Thank you so much. That was very kind
Thank
of you.
You
didn't have to.
Thank you,
I was
sir.
About to walk and get in shape, but it's a little cold out there. It was 39 degrees yesterday.
Oh, yeah.
Why is it so cold in Vegas?
It's desert cold. It's desert cold.
It's deceiving because it looks all sunlight. It looks like a nice day today. But it is like walking in ice cubes.
That's it. Right there.
All right. And Showtime. They may see you tomorrow in the background somewhere?
Yes, I will. Yes, you'll see me there.
Tune in. Showtime Boxing. Don't miss it. Thank you so much. FiyazNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter @Secback. You can follow me on Instagram @EllieSecback.